Hey, my name is Monique Starling, the owner of Mo Pies, and you have clicked on this video because one, you want to learn more about how to start your own pie business, and also, what is a cottage food license and how do I get one in California? In this video, I'm going to talk about all that and more. Before I became an official business owner, I was searching on YouTube and the internet just to find out more information. Everybody was talking about their cake business or cookie business, but not about pies. Why can't the pies get any love? In the midst of me searching and the lack of resources that I found, I decided I'm gonna make my own video. I'm gonna break down how to start your own food business in California under the cottage food license. Getting a cottage food license is a simple process, but it took me a while because I didn't know that I needed certain permits in order to obtain this one, and I was going through a loophole in the roundabout. So I finally got it together, and I can tell you, to save you the heartache and trouble of trying to figure out what you need, I will be posting all this information in the description box below, and then also throughout the video, I'll have little words and links and stuff so you can follow along. First things first, your cottage food license. If you log onto cdph.ca.gov or publichealth.lacounty.gov, there you'll find all the information you need to obtain a cottage food license. The cottage food license, aka CFO, cottage food operations, is a bill that was passed in 2012. This allows individuals to prepare and package certain non-potentially hazardous food in the privacy of your home kitchen to sell. Not sure if you qualify for a cottage food operation? Well, the website provides a checklist for you to go through to see if you need to apply. Your cottage food license application can be filled out online. So I'm doing it and I get there and I see this one question about, have you told your planning center about this? And I'm like, huh? The planning, what is this? Whew. So before you fill out your cottage food license form, you need to find your city's planning center and get approval for them to let them know that you're actually doing business. Because you can't do stuff on your own these days, you got to get approval to, if you want to build a house, if you want to do construction work, you got to get approval from the city to do it. So you go over there, it's called the planning center. You can look it up, use your Googles. I found mine, so I went there, and yes, there is a fee. The cottage food permit to do business form can be found on your city's planning center's website. This is the form here. There is a $93 fee to submit the application. Once you've done that, you can finish filling out your cottage food license form. They will ask you if you want a Class A or Class B. I did Class B because with mine, I want to be able to sell my product through a restaurant. Pimp,
pimp.
There are two cottage food operations you can apply for, Class A and Class B. A Class A allows you to sell cottage food items directly to a consumer only, and Class B allows you to also sell directly and indirectly to consumers through restaurants, grocery stores, or mobile facilities. I'm going to explain more about the requirements needed for a Class B operation.
Another question they ask you to submit in your form is send in your labels.
Like any food product that is sold, it contains a label. Your product shouldn't be any different. Read through the list to make sure you meet all the requirements. You need a header stating your product was made from here, a permit number, the county it was issued, business name, what the product is, and address, and list all of your ingredients and the net weight. Remember to highlight any ingredients that are major food allergens, like wheat, soy, and nuts.
Yeah, so once you pay the planning center people, you filled out your labels, you pay the cottage food license people, submitted your application, everything's good, right? No, because then you get an email saying, hey, you need a seller's permit and your food handler certificate. Your food handler certificate is pretty easy. They have your online classes, or you can waste money and go in. Don't do that. Don't waste money. It was, I believe, $7 or something in total to get it done. So just do it online. It's faster. So that's pretty simple. Now, getting your seller's permit is where it gets a little tricky, because you need to
actually have a business, you need a couple of things in place. One of those things that you need is your business license. Now, there are tons of videos on YouTube and information on between like the sole proprietorship, LLC, all the above. So I'm not going to get into that. I'm just going to tell you what I did and what was comfortable for me here in lovely California. So I have a DBA, which is doing business as, or aka fictitious business. Those, I believe, like $25, but you have to get a notarized, so that's like an additional $12-$15. But then with that, you need to be published in a local newspaper. I went to this newspaper called The Signal. For mine, it was like 100. You'll get an email with a picture of like your business in the newspaper. So after you've done that, you registered, you got your DBA, your official. Hooray! Then you gotta get your seller's permit. And at first I was like, do I ever need a seller's permit? I guess with the cottage food, it's like it's required. So. But I will say, as you're filling out your seller's permit, read the art. They have a lot of articles that answers a lot of questions that you could possibly have. So read through that so that you're not clicking the wrong button as you're filling stuff out.
Before you get started, you'll need a couple of things. You can see them listed here on the screen. You'll need to have an EIN number, which is like an SSN number for your business.
But there's this guy that did a thorough video on YouTube explaining how to fill out your seller's permit. So I'll post a link to his video. All right, so you submitted your cottage food license. The planning center got your money. You did your sales permit. You passed your food handler certificate. Do it online. And now, lastly, the health department has to come and check your kitchen out. I'm not gonna lie, I'm such like an overthinker. So when they were saying the health department's coming over, I'm like, everything has to be spotless. I was cleaning stuff I didn't even have. I was cleaning an attic, a fireplace. Like, I don't even have that stuff, but I was like, it just got to be clean. It was a real simple process, too, because they're not checking your whole house. They're just checking the area that you're going to be working at. So for me, it was the kitchen. So they inspect the kitchen. Everything was good, clean, sweet, and I passed. After that, and they're like, all right, well, you're good to go. You can start doing business. And there you have it. So there you have it, how Mo Pies came to be. My website is up and running now. You can check it out, specializing in pecan pie, sweet potato pie. I make the regular pie shape. I make cupcake size pies. I make candy bite size pies. It's great for parties. If you want to just have it all to yourself, you can, or if you just want to share it around. So we cover everything that you could think of, so check it out. Just feel free to leave your questions in the comments, or go to my website, www.mopiesforyou.com. I have an Instagram page, mopiesforyou. You can go on there, DM me, you can call me, I put my number somewhere. I'll respond back. I love getting feedback and answering questions so I can help you. Well, that's all I have for you for today. Make sure you're subscribed to my channel because I'm always putting something new out. Thank you for watching, and I hope this information that I gave was helpful to you and that you too can start your own business.